In this video, you will learn how to join two tables in KNIME Analytics Platform, how to configure the joiner node for the different joined modes, and finally, the differences between the value lookup and the joiner node. Let's have a look. The joiner node has two input ports, the upper port for the left table and the bottom port for the right table. In this example, the left table contains order and the relative store, and the right table contains information about each store. The column containing the store IDs is present in both tables. However, both tables contain some store IDs that is not present in the other table. Open the configuration of the joiner node. First, you have to provide the columns on which you want to join. In this case, provide the column containing the store ID in the left and right tables. You can add more joining columns by clicking the plus button. Rows from the left and the right tables are matched based on the values in these columns. If you select more than one joining column, you can specify here whether the rows are matched based on all or any values of those columns. Next, you can select which rows are included in the join result, or in other words, specifying the join mode. The Venn diagram on the right-hand side helps to understand the corresponding join mode. The option Matching Rows corresponds to the inner join mode. Matching rows and left unmatched rows correspond to the left outer join. Right unmatched rows correspond to the right outer join when selected together with the matching rows option. Selecting all three options is a full outer join. Deactivating the matching rows box outputs only the unmatched rows. The respective join modes are called anti-joins. For this example, select the inner join to keep only the stores that appear in both tables. In the Column Selection tab, you can select which columns of the two tables will be included in the join table, and specify how to handle possible duplicate column names. Execute and have a look at the results of the inner join. The join table has the columns from both tables, order number from the orders table, store type from the stores table, and the two joining columns store and store ID from both tables. The table has three rows for those stores ID that were present in both tables. Change the settings to perform the full outer join. Now the join table has all the rows from both input tables. The rows that don't have matching rows in the other table are filled with missing values. If you check the option Split join result into multiple tables, the matched rows will appear in the first output port, and the unmatched rows from the left and right tables in the second and third port respectively. Let's now have a look at one last example when there are multiple matching rows. In this table, the store 2392 appears twice. In this case, the matching row from the left table is joined with both rows from the right table with this store ID, creating duplicates in output. Notice that this is true for all types of joins, inner, left, right, and full outer join. You can see the joiner node as a more complex and powerful version of the value lookup node, although the two operations present some substantial differences. The value lookup only lets you select one matching or lookup column, while you can select multiple matching or joining columns in the joiner node, and even declare a match if only some of their values match. In the value lookup node, you can only handle multiple or no matches from the data table. The joiner node, on the other hand, gives you more freedom with the selection of inner, left, right, and full outer join. In addition to that, in case of multiple matches, it creates duplicate rows in output. Finally, the value lookup can not only filter columns of the dictionary table, while the joiner has options to filter both left and right tables. In this video, you have learned how to join two tables in KNIME Analytics Platform, how to configure the joiner node for different join modes, and the differences between the value lookup and the joiner node.